Hey there guys, what's up and welcome back to the Deadly Tower of Monsters. And apparently this thing changes every time, it changes to different movie posters.
And
now it's this one.
Here. What is this, leather? Oh, feels like leather. Alright, we're gonna start the commentary track now.
44 minutes, it's a long time. Okay. The temple's altar. Hi there, monkeys. Pew. What is a shiv? How good is the shiv? It seems like a shiv would be pretty good. Twa! Twa! Nope, the shiv sucks. Nope, don't touch me with your flaming log. Dang it! The stupid camera angle change. Okay, never mind. I don't care that much. As long as I got my Star Wars laser pistol.
I was thinking we should take a little break and get a bite to eat. You like Chinese? I know a great takeout.
Well, we're not scheduled for a break for another few hours.
Nonsense. Hey, you have to try the shrimp. It's the absolute best. But, I feel like I should warn you. Gives me horrible gas. But that's okay, we're friends, right?
Really, sir. Studio time costs a fortune. Let's just stay on schedule.
Good thinking. We could grab a real dinner together and go out for a night on the town, yeah. Two young bachelors on the prowl. Say, where do you youngsters go these days?
I don't know, where did they go? That is like a maze. A sucky maze, because there's not only like one direction to go. I like the laser pistol a lot. Out of all the guns and stuff in this, one of my favorite. It's probably my favorite. Air teleport. Blue cog. I'm glad I upgraded it. Actually, let me try the Tesla gun. Nope. Ooh, the Tesla gun is good, actually. Hey! Doesn't have a lot of range, though. That's fine. I don't need no range. I'm no weakling. I'm no weakling. I'm stuck on a wall.
You know, this movie may not have made the big splash in Hollywood or even made the budget back for that matter, but hey, in the end, I think it was still worth making just for those die-hard fans that really love it. I attended a lot of sci-fi and movie cons, and to this day,
really?
I still see fans showing up dressed as aliens and apes and dinosaurs. Does a man proud. Now, granted, their costumes aren't exactly 100% faithful to the film, and it seems that no one ever remembers them by the right name. But still, knowing that we still have fans like this promoting the film decades later, it puts a tear in this old director's eye.
Because there's never...
I get all emotional.
There's never been other movies with apes and dinosaurs. Boop. And aliens.
Ah, Tony and his insistence on lens flare. I tell you, some days it felt like he was trying to be the director. Honestly, you could see dust on the lens, so I'd just go and wipe it off myself. He would get so upset about it, too. Like my fingers
what?
Aren't clean enough to wipe the lens. Don't touch the lens. Whatever.
Has it always done that with lens flare stuff? Ow. What is this? Oh. Fight through 20 hoops, kill a large dinosaur with a dagger. I don't know. Is that how you get upgrades? Oh, this is just choose weapons. Oh, no. I want to upgrade. No, it is upgrading. I can upgrade this. Could upgrade this. No, I can't. I'll upgrade later. I want to get my mace super powered. So that he made you. Cool, right?
You're in danger. Your one speed is not enough to pass through that fan. Chance of death 100%. Retrieve the time vortex device if you wish to go any further.
Obviously.
Searching. Time vortex device detected. Device in dangerous area. Nuclear ants everywhere.
Oh yeah. Get those nuclear ants. Pew!
I felt it was an absolute necessity we have a T-Rex in this film, but we got this Serato thing instead. Of course, I went through the whole production thinking it was a T-Rex, because really, who can tell the difference anyway?
I don't know. Looks like a T-Rex to me, kind of. Was it the Shiv? I know where I'm going. Hi there, champs.
I designed this creature to reflect the human condition. Always hungry, never satisfied. The bottomless pit of the beast's stomach. I don't know, you say stuff like that in interviews and your film always wins awards.
So do we get any backstory on Dick? Why'd he travel to Gravoria in the first place? Did he do any research before landing there? Did he have a specific mission in that region of space?
Patrick,
I don't know.
If you keep getting bogged down by the details, how will you ever learn to just sit back and appreciate the work of art for what it is?
I love the inflatable rocks. Dang it. But flamethrower.
Production tip, ladies and gentlemen. No matter how sunny it is, don't store your papier-mâché props outdoors. They will get rained on. It's the law in this town. Like Occam's razor or Stockholm syndrome or... I forget what it's called.
Blue cog. I need silver cog. Occam's razor is if something can happen, it will
Whatever,
happen.
Cosmos! It's my co-pilot's body! I believe that I can repair him. Oh no! I am trapped!
Master Dick. Master Dick.
Master Dick. Wow.
Functions restored.
Go!
Threat detected. Must eliminate.
Time vortex.
Fun fact. Hey, we actually had an actor inside the robot suit moving him around. I bet you thought it was an actual robot, huh? That's how good he was. No rest breaks or anything. Hardest working actor I've ever met. What a trooper. It was a shame we couldn't afford to pay him. And of course, since he wasn't on the payroll, I couldn't officially add him to the credits. But still, what a trooper. Wish I had a dozen actors like him.
As in games? Hi. Beat it. Down. No one cares about your tuning, you guys. Alright. Guess that's health. It is health. Took me this long to figure out that's health.
Dangerous radiation detected.
Did I just freeze? Okay.
No, no, we didn't use the same material for the toxic waste as we did the slimes. I mean, why fake something when you have the real deal available? We found a place where people were just dumping the stuff away for free. I was hoping the crew members handling it might get some cool superpowers from it, but no, nothing like that.
So unsafe. I think that's the great thing.
Slimes terminated.
They're not slimes. They're radioactive waste creatures. Okay, I haven't upgraded anything. I can upgrade the Shiv. Should I? No. Get him out! I don't know what ads in game is, but... Where are they? Oh, hey. Checkpoint. Ugh, guess I have to go this way. So is this the toxic fact? Did they just, like, steal a bunch of toxic waste? Back here. Okay, well, I'm just gonna upgrade the mace to the Warhammer 6000. Let's go. I like the robot attack. Oh. Come here, buddy. I want to kill you. Ah.
I will strike down upon thee with great vengeance and furious anger.
Furious anger. Oh my gosh. Nope. Stay away. I must save Dick. What? Pyro Shepherd. Bam! You saved Dick.
Oh, robot, you're all right. And you saved the day.
You're eliminated.
Yeah.
Looks like the Emperor's days are numbered. At long last, we have assembled our team.
A lot of reviewers and fans, too, always wondered why we shot so few scenes with all three heroes in it together. I mean, we did our best to explain it. Something about the sleep chambers or staying back to protect the ape village. Really, it was just logistics. Jonathan had bowling league on Tuesdays and Thursdays, and Stacy had her karate Monday, Wednesday, wow, and Friday. Honestly, we almost never had all of them on the set at the same time. Our robot actor was in some religion that only allowed him to work on Sundays. I'm still a little skeptical about that one, though.
Sir, it's just a guy in a suit. Couldn't you have gotten just about anyone to stand in as the robot?
See? That's why you'd make a horrible director, Patrick. His touches were subtle, to say the least. But he really brought a lot of character to the robot role.
I'm gonna go with Dick because he's the mines.
If he was so indispensable, how come you didn't list the actor in the credits?
Well, let's just say it was an oversight. But I've learned my lesson. I only made the mistake 6 more times throughout my career.
Oh, and I'm the robot with time vortex or whatever. Yeah. So, back to robot. The giant fan. Oh, I love that. New skills available. Okay, 2 new skills. Increased power cooldown. Increased melee damage. Increased maximum energy. Increases ranged weapon damage. I'm gonna get a bunch of all the ranged stuff. Oh wait, I need to switch out my guns. And the armory. Have a flamethrower, I'd rather have my revolver. You need the vortex power. Okay, vortex. That's a cool power up. What? What? What the heck?
some real action. Nothing like an adrenaline boost to get our hero to really start wailing on those monsters. We were unsure how to represent a surge of adrenaline at first, but I think we nailed it. Yeah, definitely nailed it.
Definitely.
These rickety old things, the higher up they went, the more they sounded like they were gonna fall apart. I'm amazed that no one ever got hurt, or worse, riding these things. Well,
who knows?
It was the actor we originally cast for Dick's role, but we don't talk about him.
All right, I'm gonna stop this once I get to the next checkpoint. Okay, bye. Just one question, that monkey.
You really start to get a sense of how high up our heroes have been climbing here. Reminds me of how the crew always used to comment on how high everyone was. Those jokers, they'd even say it when... Hey, now what's going on?
Okay. I'll just end it here, I guess, since I died. But hope you're enjoying this, and I will see you in the next episode. Bye-bye.